Hi everyone, my name is Vikas and today we are back with a very interesting topic on accelerated mobile pages, or AMP as all of us know it as. It was launched in 2015 by Google and then adopted by many other internet companies as well. And the accelerated mobile pages are actually that allows you to load the page faster, and that's really one of the reasons why the speed and the load time of these AMP pages is significantly faster. And that's one of the reasons why we are recommending everyone to kind of adopt it across different use cases. And you can use AMP pages across multiple reasons. So the first reason would definitely be the blog, and that's probably the easiest one to kind of implement. And if you are on WordPress or any of the larger platforms, it's just a plugin away. You can install, there are various AMP plugins that allow you to take your blog and make it AMP instantly. The AMP project page, the website that they have a huge list of libraries and scripts that you can actually take up and sort of use. So in that sense, it is easy to use, but requires technical knowledge to actually execute the page as well. And we've tested this across the healthcare industry, across real estate, across BFSI and finance. We're seeing similar results come across all categories of industries as well. The impact that we actually saw from one of our healthcare brands was that we were actually able to reduce the cost per lead by 33%, and that's a phenomenal figure that we were able to achieve. And we actually saw 20% better time on site, apart from a 33% reduction in cost per lead. And there are three typical challenges we've seen when we implement AMP pages. The first one is with regards to integration of your CRM. Any kind of pixel tracking, any kind of platform integration, any kind of CRM integration is a little bit more complex in AMP because you have to follow the scripts and the format that AMP has. But if you're using Salesforce or Zoho, any of the larger ones, is relatively easy because there is documentation to help you over there. The second challenge you see is with regards to WordPress itself. If you're using WordPress and you haven't integrated AMP with it, the challenge is that you would have to update your content twice every time you make any change on the website. The third challenge we see brands facing is with regards to the inquiry form or the call to action that you have. The inquiry form, sometimes many brands have conditional questions, they have a conditional formatting. Some of this can be more complex in AMP because AMP does not allow Ajax and other elements, and that means you cannot have too much complexity in your inquiry form itself. So as long as you have a simple, straightforward form, it can be very easy to actually implement and take forward. I hope you try out AMP because 1.5 billion pages are already using AMP as of today. There's no reason why you shouldn't do it. So go try it out today. So, do follow us and do subscribe us right here, and we hope to see you watch some of our videos again.